Television is all around us. Take a look in any household, and you're almost guaranteed to see at least one television in that household, if not more. According to the AC Nielsen Company, we watch a lot of television. The average American watches more than 4 hours each day. That's the same as 28 hours per week, or 2 months nonstop per year. The average child watches television 1,680 minutes per week. And the average American youth watches television 1,500 hours per year. To fully appreciate where we currently stand with television, we should first look into the past. And so I'd like you to join me as we look into the history of television. In 1884, 24-year-old Paul Nipkow patented his electrical telescope. His perforated disc, which was about the size of a phonograph record, formed the basis of television's development. A little later, Guglielmo Marconi found a way to transmit sound through air, thus eliminating the need for cables and wires. Lee DeFrost contributed to a product called the Audion Tube, which amplified radio waves so the listeners could clearly hear the transmitted sounds. June 1907, the word television first appears in an issue of Scientific America. Vladimir Zorokin was working for Westinghouse when he developed an all-electronic system which converted visual image into electronic signals, which could then be sent through the air to receivers, which would then transform them back into visual image. Philo T. Farnsworth was working alone in California when he developed the CRT, or cathode ray tube, which is the key component in older computer monitors and television sets of today. His product much more clearly reproduced the image on screen compared to Nipkow's product. 1939. NBC showed their first commercial at the World Fair in New York City. April 30th, 1939, President Franklin D. Roosevelt was the first president to appear on television. Sarnoff also spoke as the images were displayed on television sets at the World Fair. By 1945, a total of 10 television stations were on the air in the United States alone. By the end of 1949, television had the attention of about 41% of Americans. As word of the new invention spread, televisions started to quickly replace radios. Today, television is at its best. We send high-quality digital signals through high-tech cables such as fiber optics through the ground and two cable boxes mounted under our TV sets. These boxes can even record shows so we can watch them whenever we want. With high-definition TV available and digital signal becoming the standard at the end of this year, it's clearly visible why this is happening. The images reproduced by these TVs and this type of technology is very visible and clear. With that said, I'm going to wrap up this video and hope you enjoyed this little history session. So I'm Dave from SonicCorp Studios. Thanks for watching.